The addition property of equality, basically, if I were to state it in words, we use this with equations. And with equations, we've talked about expressions so far. And expressions are just mathematical terms grouped together. With regards to mathematical, don't need that there. Mathematical terms grouped together, essentially. Equations, however, when we talk about equations, what we're really talking about are expressions that contain an equal sign. So the big thing with equation, we have an equal sign in them, hence the term equation. Now, when we talk about the addition property of equality here, what we're really saying, the way we want to put this mathematically, we would say if A, B, and C are real numbers, okay, so they're not imaginary or anything, they're real numbers, what we're saying then is that when A is equal to B, okay, so if A and B are the same, and if that's the case, then A plus C is the same as B plus C, because if A and B are equal, then if we add A to one side of C, where we have C, we could add B to the other side, we get the same value. So basically what we're saying, the addition property of equality, is that whenever we have an equation, if we want to manipulate this, we can. However, we have to do what we do to one side of this equation, or one side of the equal sign, we have to do the same thing to the other side. The way I always give the analogy in classes is, if you had two kids and were getting ice cream, you wouldn't get just one of them ice cream, because you'd have World War III on your hands. So you have to do the same thing to each side of an equation. Now, a couple very simple equations that we can look at how this actually works. If we have something like x minus 3 is equal to 5, well, we know this is an equation because of the equal sign. And really, when we're solving equations and we're wanting to find out for a variable, we always want to get that variable by itself on one side of the equal sign. So we think about this. We have x minus 3 is equal to 5. So if we want to get x by itself, so we'd like to say x is equal to, what can we do? Well, right now we're subtracting 3 from x, so if we add 3 to both sides, we have plus 3 here, plus 3 here, what we will get is x, negative 3 and positive 3 is 0, we don't have anything there, is equal to 5 plus 3 is 8. So we're really saying x is equal to 8. This is the addition property of equality. In effect, we're saying what we do to one side, we do to the other. We're adding 3 to both sides. This gives us an answer of x equals 8. If we want to check it, we plug it back in. If x is equal to 8 and our original equation is x minus 3, well, does 8 minus 3 equal 5? Yeah, it does. And that's a true statement, so we know we're correct in there. Let's look at a different example here, one that brings some our distributive property into play as well. And let's look at where we might have, let's say 5 is equal to negative 2 times 3x minus 1 minus negative 7x plus 11. Now we got a lot of things going on here, but really, this isn't that bad if we just remember our order of operations. We can get through this quite easily. 5 is equal to, we're going to distribute our negative 2 throughout, because we can't combine these terms, they're not like. So negative 2 times 3x is negative 6x. Negative 2 times negative 1 is plus 2. Now we have, remember, we're subtracting, so this is like saying negative 1 distributed throughout the second binomial here. So negative 1 times negative 7 is plus 7x. Negative 1 times 11 is minus 11. So now at this point, all we have to do is combine like terms. So we're still going to say 5 is equal to, we'll combine like terms on one side and then the other. Negative 6x plus 7x is 1x. We can just write that as x, and we've taken care of those two. 2 minus 11 is negative 9. So now we're getting to a point where we have 5 is equal to x minus 9. And remember, we're trying to get x by itself here. So basically, all we want to do is add 9 to both sides, plus 9, plus 9. And what we get is 14 is equal to x. And if we want to see if this is right, we plug it back in. Negative 2 times 3 times 14 minus 1 minus negative 7 times 14 plus 11. And if we solve through here, 3 times 14 is 42 minus 1 is 41 minus negative 7 times 14 is negative 98 plus 11 here. So we'd have negative 82 minus, let's see, what do we have here? Negative 98 plus 11 is negative 87. Negative 82 minus negative 87 is the same as saying negative 82 plus 87, which is equal to 5. And if we remember, that's what we had here. 5 is equal to that. That's our check. That's true. So we'll be back in the next one with the multiplication property of equality, where we're going to be doing a lot of the same things, except we won't be adding, we'll be multiplying. So I'll see you in the next video. Have a good one. Bye.